Good morning everyone. Here we have taken pandemic precautions. I hope you are doing the same. Today we are going to see the topic that is determination of WBC call. What are things you have to mention in your paper, especially for practical examination point of view? Aim, objective, materials, calculation. Remember, especially WBC only, because our practical is WBC call. Observation, results, interpretation. So, I said that only practical examination point of view you have to mention this everything. Procedure you should not write. Procedure which you are doing, that is only. But in Viva Voce they will ask, tell me the procedure, where you started, how you have done the calculation, everything. Okay, it doesn't mean that you have to forget the procedure. Everything you have to mention in your paper, procedure orally you can tell. Okay, so we will start this particular procedure now.
So this is our principle. The glacial acetic acid lyses the red cells while the gentian violet slightly stain the nuclei of our WBC. The blood specimen is diluted 1:20 in WBC pipette with the diluting fluid. Our today's diluting fluid name is Turk's fluid. The cells are counted under low power of the microscope by using a counting chamber, that is improved Niebuhr chamber. The number of cells in undiluted blood are reported per cubic mm or microliter of whole blood, WBC diluting fluid, especially Turk's fluid. The composition of Turk's fluid as follows: glacial acetic acid 2 ml, 1% gentian violet 1 ml, distilled water 97 ml.
For WBC count, we required hemocytometer. If you open the hemocytometer, there will be a RBC pipette, WBC pipette, Niebuhr chamber, cover slip, watch glass, WBC diluting fluid, especially Turk's fluid, aseptic lancet, spirit, cotton. These are the requirement material. Keep it ready. Okay, so now I have cleaned, I have kept the cover slip in the Niebuhr chamber, even I have focused under that particular microscope, that is low power. Now we are going to check our WBC pipette is dried or not. You can see that bead, see how freely the bead is moving, which denoting inside is fully dried. Marking of WBC pipette 0.5 1 11, this is the identification of WBC. Second is the pore size. Inside pore you can see how broader the particular bulb is, narrow bead, inside the bead is white color, the mouthpiece is again white. This is the identification of WBC pipette. Okay, now the close that particular box and keep it aside. Take the watch glass, transfer the particular WBC diluting fluid, transfer little amount which is required amount, don't take entire, don't contaminate the particular diluting fluid by inserting the sample, or directly you can take the diluting fluid from here which is contaminate this entire bottle. So transfer adequate amount of diluting fluid which is required. Okay, the setup is now ready. Now we are going to take the blood sample from the subject.
Subject will be there, or you can choose your own finger. Remember, little finger, thumb, these two you have to ignore. You can choose among these three. Preferred finger is ring finger, middle finger. Okay, once you have utilized these two, then you go with index finger. So most preferable finger is ring finger. Tell the subject to show the ring finger like this. Now you have to do gentle massage, don't do vigorously. So don't do that. Gently you just warm the particular finger like this. Once you have done it, take the spirit cotton, wipe towards upward movement like this. Okay, like this you wipe. Once you have wiped, don't forget to discard this cotton swab to the dustbin, and you should not blow this. Just wait it is automatically get dried up.
Bold prick, first drop he wants to wipe, and
we are going to take that sample up to 0.5 mark.
When you start taking blood, there should not be air entry into the pipette. If it is so, you have to start from the beginning again by discarding this content.
Followed by
same when you are filling the diluting fluid. If it is air entry is there, try to discard it and start from the beginning again.
WBC diluting fluid up to the mark 11, and horizontally we want to mix it. Once you have mixed it, keep it aside.
So now we have transferred the particular sample and we have to mix thoroughly before charging. Okay. So now cover slip, everything I kept ready. Take the same watch glass, the stem part of the solution, that is only containing diluting fluid. Even though if you charge it, you can't able to see anything. So first few drops I'm going to eliminate or discard. See, don't contaminate the area which watch glass you are using, there only you use. Now you see how I'm going to charge it. See, it is overcharged. Now I'm going to show that undercharge. See, the students will undercharge like this and they will focus. Okay, now this is optimum charge. Okay, so now we will focus under microscope, make it low power first and then go with focusing. Okay, you have to start that particular counting like this, follow the L rule. So now we have transferred the particular sample and we have to mix thoroughly before charging. Okay, so now cover slip, everything I kept ready. Take the same watch glass, the stem part of the solution, that is only containing diluting fluid. Even though if you charge it, you can't able to see anything. So first few drops I'm going to eliminate or discard. See, don't contaminate the area which watch glass you are using, there only you use. Now you see how I am going to charge it. See, it is overcharged.
Ready.
Now I am going to show that undercharge. See, the students will undercharge like this and they will focus. Okay. Now optimum charge manje kai, what is the meaning of optimum charge? See, this is optimum charge. Okay, so now we will focus under microscope, make it low power first and then go with focusing. Okay, you have to start that particular counting like this, follow the L rule.
If you focus under microscope, you can able to see the four corner square, that is for WBC count. And once you focused, you can able to see the cells like this, wherever I have given the pinpoint mark. So that is your WBC. So here we have to follow that L rule. Some of the students asked me, please explain in detail. So here you can see that which one is L rule. You can choose either this manner or this manner, is up to you, but should be constant entire counting of the cell. So this is WBC, you have to start here, you have to go like this. Okay, and this is the L rule. So here for example I have taken this kind of L, not this. So whatever it is there in this cell I have to count, so that is black color. The faint one is we have to omit it, that is not comes under to this particular square. Now the calculation part. The calculation of RBC and WBC very similar. You just go through that RBC video, you will come to know how to calculate, how I got this 1 mm and into 1 mm into 1/10 entire. So here only the changes were dilution factor. The dilution factor is 1:20. So just follow that RBC video, you will come to know this. Now we are going to see the normal range of total leukocyte count. In adult, 4000 to 11000. At birth, 18000, which is can be calculated plus or minus 8000. 1 year, 6000 to 15000. 2 years to 6 years, 5000 to 15000. 6 to 12 years, 5000 to 13000. At pregnancy, up to 15000 cells per cubic mm. So it may varies, but if there is no difference between male have more, female have less, like this, with what we have discussed in RBC count. There is no gender difference, only age difference. So here, upright aspects are clinical based. Increase decrease of WBC count. Certain medical term we have to use here. When the WBC count is increases, either it is physiological or pathological, we have to use leukocytosis. When it is decrease, it's known as leukopenia. So based on this, I have given here the physiological and pathological conditions. If you have any doubt, you can put to the comment box. I will clarify later.
Once you have done, remove the Neuber chamber carefully. Clear this particular sample thoroughly with that cotton and cover slip also. Once you have done, wash it in the running tap water and discard this entire lancet and whatever cotton swab we have used and report it to your technician who is ever available. So thank you so much. We will see in the next part.